Holy smokes. Oshkosh, it is the pivotal aviation aerospace event in the world. But where else would you expect to find Blue Origin? Why are you here?
Well, we're like you said, this is a big air show. There's more than 500,000 people here. And we wanted to come to a place that had maximum impact, a place where we could introduce our rocket to a large number of people, our crew capsule mock-up, and allow people to experience what it's going to be like to fly on Blue Origin.
There is a tremendous amount of anticipation from the public. They see this as a part of their future. What do you want the public to know about the path going forward? Because let's face it, we know the one line, space is hard.
Well, we have a vision of a future where there's millions of people living and working in space. To date, only about 550 people have flown into space, and we really want to, everything we do, every vehicle and every system we work on is focused on that goal of opening up the space frontier to more people. So in that future, we're living in low Earth orbit, we're living on the moon, and we're living on other planets and coming back to Earth and maintaining Earth's pristine beauty.
What have been the surprises of all this? I mean, let's face it, there's nothing normal about what we're doing anymore. One of my favorite words I learned at the right hand of Peter Diamandis is disruption. And disruption is a good thing.
Yeah. Well, disruption is a great thing. And bringing commercial companies into the space industry, bringing private money, that's all generated by the passion that was created by flying the Apollo astronauts to the moon back in the 60s. And we grew up with that, and that passion has stuck with us, and we want to do something different in the space industry. We want reusability. And so building New Shepard to demonstrate reusability was the key first step for Blue Origin. And that is the essential step for lowering costs. So first you need that reusable vehicle, and then you need to fly it at rate. We flew it 5 times last year. We learned a lot of small little things that we can use to go back and redesign and fix things, change things to make it more operable. But what we really want is operational reusability. And operational reusability is what's going to bring the cost to a point where average people can go and fly into space and we can start to increase the numbers. But it's going to take time. It's going to take decades to get to that point where we have those large numbers of people in low Earth orbit and beyond. But we're totally committed to it.
How important is the burgeoning space tourism industry, which is a bit moribund lately because, let's face it, it took longer than anybody wanted to take and probably as long as everybody expected. But how important is that to being able to get the acceptance and, in the long run, getting the support of the community necessary to go forward?
Yeah, it has taken longer than anyone expected, but it is critically important because it represents a huge potential market. And so, not unlike the barnstormers of early aviation that brought flying to normal folks coming out to a local airfield, commercial space and suborbital space tourism is going to bring that experience to a larger number of people. It's critically important.
What advice do you give to the kids coming up through grade, middle, and high school right now and heading for college to be able to land a job with Blue Origin and find a future in space?
That's a great question. Starting out, you know, middle school, high school, get into some kind of a hands-on build project that really gets you exposed to building things like flying, like robotics. FIRST is an international organization, really, that gets young people involved in robotics at the Lego level and then building robots that do tasks. We see a lot of those folks going on into aerospace and mechanical engineering. Once you're in college, if engineering is a path you choose, internships, and I shouldn't just limit it to engineering because we hire business people, we hire lawyers, we hire people in all ranges of areas, technicians, people that are, you know, machinists. But getting into something that's going to expose you to building and working on projects is going to be a great, great step for you.
You're about to field a new Shepard. What's the initial deployment of that vehicle going to look like within the confines of what you can say at this point?
It'll look very similar to the rocket right here next to me, except it'll be shinier because it won't have flown. It'll have some subtle changes to the thermal protection systems, to the electronic systems and the software. They won't be changes that you really would notice, you know, to the casual eye, but they'll help us turn the vehicle around faster. We actually have a fleet of 3 vehicles that we're building right now. The first one will be heading to the test site, you know, soon, in the next few months. So
we look forward to your continued success. We know this is a tremendously hard task at this point, but more important, you and few others are leading the way to something that I grew up with, and darn it, it's come a little later than I'd like, but I'm glad to see it happen, and good on you for it.
Thank you so much. I'm just happy to be here and help in any way I can. It's an exciting industry, and we're going to just make it even more so.
Aero-TV is brought to you by
your Cessna 172 or 177 wants a TrueTrack autopilot, and so do many others. Visit TrueTrackAP.com and get your airplane added to the model list. The TrueTrack autopilot at TrueTrackAP.com.
Redbird Flight Simulations is dedicated to revolutionizing flight training by designing, manufacturing, and delivering affordable and innovative flight training technologies. Each Redbird device is designed to enhance the training experience for pilots of all levels, from student to ATP. Redbird is quickly becoming the industry standard for flight training. Since Redbird introduced its revolutionary FMX in 2007, colleges, universities, and flight training operations around the world have integrated Redbird products into their curriculum. It's time to discover what Redbird can do for you. Join the migration.